I am excited to introduce to you our new microarchitecture, previously codenamed Gracemont. When we started this journey, we wanted to deliver a scalable microarchitecture that could address computing needs across our entire spectrum of products, from low-power mobile applications to many core microservices. Our primary goal was to build the world's most efficient x86 CPU core. We wanted to do that while still delivering more IPC than Intel's most prolific CPU microarchitecture to date, Skylake. We also set an aggressive silicon area target so that multi-core workloads could be scaled out using as many cores as necessary. With these architectural anchors in place, we also wanted to deliver a wide frequency range. This allows us to save power by running at low voltage and creates headroom to increase frequency and ramp up performance for more demanding workloads. Finally, we wanted to provide rich ISA features, such as advanced vector and AI instructions that accelerate modern workloads. I am pleased to say that we delivered on all of our goals. It's my honor to introduce Intel's newest efficient x86 core microarchitecture. Thanks to a deep front end, a wide back end, and a design optimized to take advantage of Intel 7, this CPU core delivers a breakthrough in multi-core performance. Let's now dive deeper into the details, starting with the front end. The first aspect in driving efficient IPC is to make sure we can process instructions as quickly as possible. This starts with accurate branch prediction. Without accurate branch prediction, much of the work ends up being unused, which is wasteful. We implemented a 5,000 entry branch target cache. We complemented it with a long history-based branch prediction. This helps us quickly generate accurate instruction pointers. With accurate branch prediction, things like instruction cache misses can be discovered and remedied early, before becoming critical to program execution. Workloads like web browsers, databases, packet processing, these all benefit from these capabilities. We also have a 64 kilobyte instruction cache that keeps the most useful instructions close without expending power in the memory subsystem. This microarchitecture features Intel's first on-demand instruction length decoder, which generates pre-decode information that's stored alongside the instruction cache. This gives us the best combination of characteristics, where code that has never been seen before is decoded quickly, yet the next time it's executed, we bypass the length of the decoder and save energy. The new core also features Intel's revolutionary clustered out-of-order decoder that enables decoding up to 6 instructions per cycle while maintaining the energy efficiency of a much narrower core. It also includes hardware-driven load balancing, which takes long chains of sequential instructions and automatically inserts toggle points to ensure parallelism. The second main aspect to achieving performance is ensuring you extract any parallelism inherent in the program. With 5 wide allocation, 8 wide retire, a 256 entry out of order window, and 17 execution ports, this microarchitecture delivers more general integer IPC than Intel's Skylake core while consuming a fraction of the power. The execution ports are scaled to the unique requirements of each unit, which maximizes both performance and energy efficiency. 4 general purpose integer execution ports are complemented by dual integer multipliers and dividers. We can also resolve 2 branches per cycle. Now, for vector operations, we have 3 SIMD ALUs. The SIMD integer multiplier supports Intel's virtual neural network instructions. 2 symmetric floating point pipelines allow executing 2 independent add or multiply operations. Thanks to advanced vector extensions, we can also execute 2 floating point multiply add instructions per cycle. Advanced crypto units round out the vector stack, which provide AES and SHA acceleration. Now, the final aspect to achieving efficient performance is a fast memory subsystem. 2 load pipelines plus 2 store pipelines enable 32-byte read and 32-byte write bandwidth at the same time. The L2 cache, which is shared among 4 cores, can be 2 or 4 megabytes, depending on product level requirements. This large L2 provides high performance and power efficiency for single-threaded workloads by keeping data close. It also provides enough bandwidth to service all 4 cores. The L2 can provide 64 bytes of read bandwidth per cycle with 17 cycle latency. The memory subsystem has deep buffering and each four-core module can have up to 64 outstanding misses to the last level cache and beyond. Advanced prefetchers exist at all cache levels to automatically detect a wide variety of streaming behavior. Now, Intel Resource Director technology ensures that software can control resources among the cores. A robust set of security features, along with having an ISA that can support a wide range of data types, is important for every new microarchitecture. We support features like Intel Control Flow Enforcement Technology and Intel Virtualization Technology Redirection Protection. We put additional focus on security validation and developed several novel techniques to harden against certain attack vectors to maintain tight security. We also implemented the AVX ISA along with new extensions to support integer AI operations. This allows software to run with great performance. In addition to choosing what to include, one of the most important aspects of designing new microarchitecture is deciding what not to include. We balance this trade-off by focusing on those features that were needed and keeping out the rest. This results in area efficiency, which in turn allows products to scale out the number of cores. This also helps reduce energy per instruction. Now, minimizing power is the biggest design challenge for today's processors. Power is a combination of multiple factors, of which voltage is the most important. This microarchitecture and our focused design effort allow us to run at low voltage to reduce power consumption, while at the same time creating the power headroom to operate at higher frequencies. Okay, now let's take a look at the results of this new design. First, looking at latency, if we compare our core to a single Skylake core for a single logical process, we deliver 40% more performance at the same power. Now, we also deliver the same performance while consuming less than 40% of the power. To say it differently, a Skylake core would consume 2.5 times more power to achieve the same performance. This is a tremendous achievement. However, we're even more excited about the throughput results. If we compare 4 of our new CPU cores against 2 Skylakes running 4 threads, we deliver 80% more performance while still consuming less power. Alternatively, we deliver the same throughput while consuming 80% less power. Again, this means that Skylake would need to consume 5 times the power for the same performance. As you can imagine, these are very exciting results for us. What makes all of this truly incredible is when you consider that we can deliver 4 of our new cores in a similar footprint as a single Skylake core. In conclusion, we are extremely proud of our new highly scalable microarchitecture. Thanks to our deep front-end innovations, our wide back-end, and design optimizations using Intel 7, we created a microarchitecture that excels at throughput efficiency. We exceed Skylake core performance while consuming less power in a smaller footprint. I want to thank all of the talented engineers on the architecture and design teams, and I also want to acknowledge the support we got from everyone within the company. Thank you for your time.